Hey, Al, it's Cloudy with Crazy Island Studios. We're having morning coffee. It looks gross because there's cinnamon in it, so it looks like it's dirty, but it tastes good. It tastes good. So my allergies are out of control today. I don't know why. It rained, like poured, two nights ago. I don't understand what's floating around in the air that's making me crazy, but what's going on? First, I want to welcome all of my new subscribers. I do have quite a few that have come on recently, and especially since the hashtag Love Summer Art Project, I have some more new subscribers. So I just want to welcome you to my channel. Thank you so much for being here. I appreciate every one of you for subscribing, and I'm glad that you're here. We're going to have fun together. Yay! I am moving. If you don't already know this, if you're newer to my channel, you haven't, you know, heard all the stuff leading up to this, but I am moving from California, Fresno, California, to Hawaii, to the Big Island of Hawaii on the Hilo side, and I'm really excited. It's going to be a new grand adventure. We're going to be living off-grid until we can get, you know, our system set up. We'll still be off the grid, but we will eventually have power and water and all those good things that you kind of need, or at least I need. Oh my gosh. So I just wanted to give you guys a quick update of what's happening with the move. We leave tomorrow. Today's Monday, right? Yeah. So we leave tomorrow, which is Tuesday. Of course, like you wouldn't know that. Forgive me, my brain's not all here. We leave tomorrow to drive to Oakland because I have to drop my car off at the port and drop all the kids off at the hotel. Drop all them off first, go to the port, drop off my car, and then I get to figure out how to find dinner for everybody in the hotel with no car, and pizza's not really an option for one of my kids, so we'll figure something out. And then we fly out tomorrow morning from Oakland to Kona, which is on the other side of my island, and that's for the dogs. Yeah. They require some stuff. I've had quite a few of you check with me to make sure that I know about the whole quarantine situation over there. I do want to reassure you that yes, we did our research like we should, and we have actually started about 8 or 10 months ago getting everything in order and making sure that we had everything done properly so that we could have our pets direct release to us. They do not have to sit in quarantine because their quarantine is 4 months. I just can't imagine that that's very psychologically healthy for my pets. They're actually flying in the cabin with us, so they will never leave our care, which is kind of cool. And fortunately, we were actually able to rent a house for the first month, so that's really good. That means that life will be pretty easy because I'm just moving into a vacation rental for a month, basically, that is directly across the road from my property. Things are just working out, right? Things are just working out. So I'm really excited about that. Hold on, I have to move. Does anybody else sit with like one foot tucked up under them and then forget that your foot's under there until it's like dead and it's screaming in pain? That's me all the time. So anyways, yeah, we have a rental house for the first month. This is not working. Okay. So we have a rental house for the first month that we're there, which is awesome. It'll give us a chance to kind of get acclimated to what's happening because it's different. It's all different. And that'll be good. It'll help my daughter when she starts school to, you know, have a home to come home to and all of that good stuff until we start this grand adventure of being off-grid, which is happening in a month. This gives my husband and the boys some time to build us some cabins because time constraints didn't allow them to get some of that stuff done ahead of time. And we're arriving a month earlier than expected because school starts a month earlier than we expected. So things just kind of have to just happen. So for the first month, I'll have power and I'll have running water and I'll have all the conveniences of a home and all that good stuff. And then we're basically going to be camping, which is cool. I like camping, but we'll be doing it with walls around us, not a tent, and real beds. That's the important part, real beds. Other than that, I can deal with a lot of the whole thing. It's not hot or cold there, so an outdoor kitchen sounds like fun. I don't mind a camp kitchen. We used to camp all the time until my back got too bad to sleep on those air mattresses. So yeah, it's going to be fun. It's going to be an adventure. I'll keep you guys along with that. But for at least the first month, I shouldn't have any trouble with the whole recording schedule other than finding a space in the rental house to set aside to record in, but I will find a corner somewhere and I will get something out for you guys. So things shouldn't change too incredibly much other than I'm going to be busy and I may not get things done as perfectly on schedule as I would like to. So I'm asking for your patience. My regular uploading schedule is Freedom Journal Fridays, and I started the Art Journaling 101, which kind of has not been consistent, and that will get better. I do want to start a Deco Art Monday series because I was accepted into the Helping an Artist program from Deco Art, and they did provide me a bunch of supplies to make stuff for you guys, so that's what I'm doing. And so I will be having those come out. So things are going to start rolling a little bit more. I'm going to try and be present with you guys more often because you guys are so much fun. I really like hanging out with you. So that's what that's the core of what I really am really enjoying doing, is making YouTube videos, hanging out with you guys, getting to know you, and all of that great stuff. So things shouldn't change. I have an internet situation figured out. For now, anyways, it will function. I was able to go to my cell phone company and get a little device that I'll plug into my computer, and I get 20 gigabytes of data a month, which is not that much, but it's not that little either because I won't be sharing it. It's all mine. And if I get to where that becomes a little bit of a problem, I'll go to Starbucks once a week and upload. I like Starbucks. I don't mind hanging out there and drinking free refills on my iced coffee, or my iced tea. And although, you know, we have 20 acres of jungle in the middle of beautiful Hawaii, in the middle of all kinds of other 20-acre jungle lots, we're only like 15 minutes from town and like half an hour from the like biggest city right there on our side. So it's kind of the best of both worlds, right? So you get like country living, but you know, I can still drive really quick to a gas station or whatever it is that I need, so that's kind of nice. You know, the grocery store's not that far away, so it's actually pretty okay. So my uploading schedule will, you know, it'll still be happening. I just have to ask you guys for a little bit of patience as I go through this transition. Hopefully by next week I'll get something done for you guys, right? If I have to hold the camera in my hand and paint with the other hand, it's the garbage monster. That's the garbage monster making all that noise. Let's wait. Okay, I think he's far enough away now that he's not going to be like super loud on the video. So yeah, I'll get something out for you guys next week. Somehow, some way, I'll do it. I will. So that's my goal anyway. But be patient with me if something happens. But I will do my best to get back on track, and I really have a goal to just make more content for you guys on a regular basis because you know, you're why I do this, and I couldn't do it without you guys. So yeah, I want to make more stuff with you guys and hang out with you more. Speaking of hanging out with you more, comments. Please comment on the videos if you have something to say or if you have questions. I love. This is like my favorite part of YouTube, because I can make you guys videos and you get to see me and hear me and know what's going on in my world, but I need to hear from you too, because then I can communicate with you and get to know each other. So that's the fun part for me. I love all the new people that I've got to meet all through YouTube. Like, I have some people now that I communicate with that are just amazing. And it wouldn't have happened if they didn't comment on a video so I could comment back to them. And I will reply to every single one of your comments. So if you have questions, I will answer them. If you have video ideas, throw those at me. If you just want to tell me your artwork's awesome or it sucks, okay, go ahead. Leave me comments. Actually, I prefer the nice ones though. Like, so maybe if you think it sucks, maybe not so much on the comment. You know. So yeah, I do. I love hearing from you guys. I have no idea what that huge noise is. So if you can hear it, I'm sorry. I'll try to get it out in the editing. If you can't hear it, cool. Close the window a little bit. Hopefully that'll help. It was getting like obnoxious to me. So as far as comments go, yes, I will reply to your comments. I love communicating with you guys. But I have noticed that some of you, I can't reply. It makes me crazy because I at least want to say thank you. But on some of them, I cannot reply. So if you left a comment and you haven't got a reply, I try to like tag you in it, but sometimes the name won't pop up. So I will try to reply in like a separate comment sometimes. But if I can't get your name to pop up, you're never going to see it unless you come looking for it. And who does that? Nobody. So I thumbs up. I'll click the thumbs up. I liked your comment. If I did that, please know that I saw it and I was not able to reply. I'm assuming it's privacy settings or something, and if you want to change those so that I can reply, cool. If you don't, just understand that's why. And if you have a question and you want to keep your privacy settings on YouTube so that I can't reply to your comment, email me. Feel free to email me. I'll respond. I reply. My email is crazyislandstudios@gmail.com. Happy to help you guys out. Or if you have questions or you want to send me a picture or whatever, you can communicate with me through email. You can communicate with me through here. You can also join my Facebook group. I have a Facebook page, which is my business page, where I post stuff. So if you want to be, you want to get all like the updates and stuff, make sure you head over there, like Crazy Island Studios at Facebook. And then once you do that, under the liked, there's a little drop down arrow, and you have to click that little drop down arrow and choose get updates, or you won't always get my updates. So yeah, make sure that you do that after you like my page. And then also I have a Facebook group, which is basically you guys, all of you Crazy Islanders who have joined me here on Crazy Island. And why I was like, oh my gosh, I have so many amazing people who are talking to me. They need to talk to each other, because there's good stuff there, and there's great people, and there's encouragement. And so I started Crazy Island Family Facebook group, and oh my gosh, it's like the best group ever. Okay, well, maybe not ever, but it's pretty awesome in my opinion. So basically it's a place where you can join, and all you gotta do is put in your request. We'll make sure that you're real and that you're not a spammer, and then we'll let you in, and then you can just jump into the group, and it's awesome. And it's basically a bunch of other Crazy Islanders who decided to head on over, get to know each other, and it's a fantastic community. There are so many wonderful, nice people, and then you can post your work so I can see it, and you can see everybody else's work, and they can see your work and comment it and help you if you need critique. So it's been actually really awesome. We have a really positive atmosphere in the group. There are some group guidelines. If you do join, please make sure you read through those. Just to kind of keep things on an even keel, and my basic goal is to keep it all very friendly. Very friendly, very supportive, and a safe place, especially for those of you who are new to art journaling. I want it to be a safe place for you to post your work and get feedback and learn some stuff. So it is a great community for that. We have some amazing admins who are helping me take care of that site, and they make sure that you feel welcome. I have some members who are not admins, who are just awesome, awesome, awesome Sandra. You know who I'm, some of you I'm talking to, who comment on every single new member and welcome them. You guys are awesome. So you will feel welcomed, and we will love you and appreciate you if you want to join our group. So that's basically it for my quick little update. Things are crazy, and I have so many plans. I have so many things I want to talk to you guys about. I have so many. I have like a huge, monstrous list of ideas for Art Journaling 101, because I really want to be a help to those of you who are new to art journaling, and help you figure out and just navigate this crazy world of products, because there's a crap ton of stuff out there for you to learn about and to play with and to spend all of your dollars on. Because that's what we do. We spend all of our dollars in the art store on Blick.com. Oh, I want to tell you guys about a website that I found called Artist Supply Source, right? Artist Supply Source. I will double check that that website, and I will get you guys that website, because oh my gosh, like deals. I got the Dina Wakely, what are those, the fine tip applicators that are usually like $10 for two, everywhere else $6 for two. Oh, I'm so excited about this site. I can't wait to like look around and buy more. I just grabbed a few things, but if you are looking for an inexpensive place to supplement some stuff, Artist Supply Source. I just found them. Love them. Okay, so that's it for this supposedly quick update, because I don't do anything quick. It all gets really long. But thanks for hanging out with me. Thanks for being a part of this amazing YouTube adventure with me. I love every single one of you. I appreciate you. Thank you very much for being here. And I will see you guys all again very soon. Ooh, from Hawaii. Yay. Bye for now.